Good morning, dear students. In the previous class, we have studied about the public and private sector, and now we are going to study the different forms of organizations that are taken in the public sector, or we can say about the public sector enterprises, different type of public sector companies. Okay. So we have studied in the last chapter that what are the forms of organization that a private sector can take. Like we studied about sole proprietorship, partnership, joint stock, Hindu joint family business, then cooperative society, as well as the joint stock company. So these are the forms of organization that a private sector company can take. Okay, all these are coming in the category of a private sector. Now we are going to study what are the different type of organization that we can that a public sector company can take. Okay, so now let us see what is about the public sector. In the public sector, as it grows, an important question arises in respect of how it is to be organized or what form of organization it should take. The government has a major role to play in the formation of the public sector. So the government has the major role of starting up the public sector, or the public sector is controlled by the government. But the government acts through its people, its officers, employees, and take decisions on behalf of the government. Okay, so the government cannot take any work by itself. So what it can do is that it will be doing the work by the people. Okay, so the government will be doing the activities by its people, or we can say that by its officers or employees, and they are making decisions for the government. For this purpose, public sector enterprises were formed by the government to participate in the economic activities of the country. They are expected to contribute to the economic development of the country in today's liberalized competitive world. These public sector enterprises are owned by the public and are accountable to the public through the parliament. They are characterized by public ownership, public funds being used for its activities, and public accountability. Okay, so the public sector means that it is of the people. That is the meaning of this one. It is owned by people. Okay, we are all. See, like if we are like the money that we are paying to the government is used for this work purpose. So that is why it is known as the public sector. Mostly, like we can say, public sector means it is owned by the government. But government is not the actual owners of it. We are the owners of it. So that is why all the people in the country is considered as the owners of the business or owners of this type of institution. So we can say like these are our own institutions. Like if you consider a school, a government school in our locality, we can say that it is our own school. Okay, so because it is made by our money, the tax that we have paid is the source of income which is used for that. So it is our responsibility to take care of that and see to it that the things are functioning properly. Okay, but most of the time what we are thinking is that when people consider these type of institutions as the somebody else's, you know, so we don't consider that it is of our own. A public enterprise may take any particular form of organization depending upon the nature of its operations and their relationship with the government. The suitability of a particular form of organization would depend upon its requirement. At the same time, in accordance with the general principles, any organization in the public sector should ensure organizational performance, productivity, and quality standards. So there are some quality standards that the public sector enterprise has to keep up. Okay, so those standards has to be maintained, and there are some formalities that the public sector enterprises has to keep up. So thus those things will be kept. And the forms of organization which a public sector enterprise may take are as follows. So there are three types of public sector enterprises. The first one is called as the departmental undertaking, the statutory corporation, and the government company. There are three forms of organization. So in private sector we studied that there are five forms of organizations, and in public sector there are three forms of organization: the departmental undertaking, statutory corporation, and government company. Okay, so these three forms are there. Now we are going to study about the first one, that is called the departmental undertaking. This is the oldest and the most traditional form of organization, public organizing public enterprises. These enterprises are established as the department of the ministry and are considered part of an extension of the ministry itself. So this departmental undertaking means that this is the particular department of the government or the ministry. So it is considered as a one part of the ministry or one part of the government. Okay, so it is like a government department. The government functions through these departments, and the activities performed by them are an integral part of the functioning of the government. They have not been constituted as autonomous or independent institutions, and as such are not independent legal entities. So they are not created individual as an individual company or an individual institution. It is not there. It is part of the government. It is a part of the ministry. So there is no any legal titles or a particular entity features are not there. Okay. So autonomous rights are not there. Autonomous means to function independently without the interference of any other people. But here it is not like that. It is fully controlled by the government. It means that it is under the control of the government itself. Okay. So they act through the officers of the government, and its employees are government employees. These undertakings may be under the central or state government, and the rules for the central government or state government are applicable. Examples of these undertakings are railways and post and telegraph department. Okay, so these organizations are handled by the government, and the employees of these departments are considered as the government employees. There is no any difference between the government employees and the departmental employees. So they are part of the government department, and these employees are considered as the government employees itself, and all the features or all the facilities that are available to the government employees will be available for the employees of these organizations also. Okay, and the treasury, the money that is going for this one is specially used by the government treasury. There is no any particular fund for this one. So the money is used by the government money, or the government treasury is used for the purpose of handling this type of activities. Okay, and they can be under the state government or maybe the central government. Either the central government will be controlling the activities, or the state government will be there. So some of the examples of these departmental undertakings are railways and post and telegram department. Post and telegraph department is a best example of this one. Railways. So railways are considered controlled by the central government, and post and telegram department is also controlled by the central government. So there are also some kind of institutions which is run by the state governments, or either it is by the central government or by the state government, or maybe partially by state and partially by the central government. Okay, so such a way this will be handled. Now let us discuss the features. What are the main features of the this departmental undertaking? Okay, the main characteristics of the departmental undertakings are as follows. The funding of these enterprises come directly from the government treasury, and are annual appropriation from the budget of the government. The revenue earned by these is also paid into the treasury. So the capital or the fund is to be coming from the government treasury, and a particular budget, when the budget is made, a particular appropriation is made. One like a railway budget, especially for railway itself, there is a particular budget is there. Normal budget is submitted, and other than that, the railway budget is separately submitted. Okay, so the budget or the money that is used for the these departments are particularly used. Government treasury, the money is used from the government treasury, and this there is a particular appropriation is made. One like particular portion is made separate for the departments. So different departments are there. So this much money is to be for this department, and allocate such a way the government will be allocating some money for the these departments. They are subject to accounting and auditing controls applicable to other government activities. So accounting and auditing is done by all the other government institutions or government authorities under that whatever activities are performed. So for that auditing and accounting is done the same way the accounting and auditing is done for the government departments also. The employees of the enterprise are government servants and their recruitment and conditions of service are the same as that of the other employees directly under the government. They are headed by Indian Administrative Service IAS officers and civil servants who are transferable from one ministry to another. So the employees of the government department are appointed directly by the government and it is administrated or the controlled by IAS officers. Okay, so there are IAS officers are there, so they are handling the activities of this. And these employees can be maybe like if one person is appointed as in charge of a railway, it doesn't mean that he will become always the in charge of that. Or one is in charge of postal department, he will not be there in that. So he can be transferred from one to another, means one department to another, because all the activities are under the control of the government. And it is generally considered to be a major subdivision of the government department and is subject to direct control of the ministry. So it is considered as a one department or one part of the government and it is controlled by the ministry itself or government itself. So full control is held by the government. They are accountable to the ministry since their management is directly under the concerned ministry. So the accountability is given to the ministry. The ministry means if the performance level of this department is not well, then this like IAS officers or the members or in charges are there, so they have to give account to the this accountability is means accountability means the like answerability. If the functions are not doing it properly, then they have to answer to the government department, government ministry. Okay, so that is all the features. The remaining portions we will study in the next class. Okay, thank you so much.